And what did you want to know, really?
The answer is a mechanism of development. How is it that this one cell becomes a mass of cells? And what different ways can it happen among, of course, that was Cap's interest, Cap Weston's interest. And there just seemed to be infinite possibilities. But I'll tell you a story about this, which comes when I was a graduate student. And I was working on them and had already done that film, early film I did, which was better than anything else I did. I was asked to, as a graduate student, to go to Yale to give a seminar. So I assumed that it would be a small group of cryptogamic botanists. And I arrived there, and I was absolutely terrified because it was in a big lecture room with a whole botany department and a whole zoology department. And so I gave my seminar. And I was fascinated afterwards because people really didn't show any interest in my brilliant experiments. They were only interested in hearing about the life cycle of the organism. And it was really quite amazing. And after it was all over, I was going up to get a cup of tea, and suddenly there was this voice behind me saying, "Bonner, if I had to start all over again, I'd work with those slime molds." And this was Ross Harrison, who was probably the greatest embryologist ever was, and a very modest, kindly sort of person. And anyhow, that was a big moment.